Hello there gamers, and welcome back to another epic Inexorable Maths video. In this video, we're taking another look at completing the square. We're looking at solving some more difficult problems. The reason why we're doing this is because completing the square can be difficult. So we're going to take another video before we do our quadratic formula stuff, which I said that we would do. We're going to do another video looking at some harder problems for completing the square. We're going to try and just do this manually without the formula that we've written over there. But the formula is there. So this is the completing the square part of the formula. This is the bit where we know we're talking about a quadratic. Y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, which is also equal to all of this. And remember, we found out why it's equal to this in the previous video when we derived the formula as we see there for completing the square. So there is a derivation in the previous video if you want to see that. But for now, we're going to be taking a look at this question here, y equals x squared plus 6x plus 10. We haven't actually looked at a question where we've got a plus c on the end. So let's try that now. Although we're going to start fresh, nice and easy. A is just going to be 1, but we will do some where A is not 1 in this video. Okay, so first things first, what do we do? Y is also going to be equal to, okay, that's our B, right? A is 1, B is 2, C is 10. We're looking at half of B, aren't we, every time? So we're going to open up the bracket. We recognize that A is equal to 1, so we can do what we're about to do. We're just going to put an X there, and we're going to add half of B. B is positive 6, so we're going to add 3, like so. We're going to square the whole thing, and then we are going to see what this is equal to. So this is equal to, I'm just going to tell you, x squared plus 6x plus 9. Don't believe me, just try it yourself. It's x squared plus 6x plus 9. Okay, we want x squared plus 6x, not plus 9, but plus 10. So normally, if that 10 wasn't there, what we would normally do is take 9 away, wouldn't we? We'd take 9 away because we would just be looking at x squared plus 6x, and that's how we would get x squared plus 6x. We would say minus 9, which is technically true. We can do that, but we haven't dealt with this 10. So we're going to add a 10 on. In other words, what is that? Minus 9 plus 10? That's positive 1, right? So in other words, this is another thing that you can do. You can say, I have got, by getting this, I have got the x squared, the 6x, and 9, but I want 10. I have 9, I want 10. I'm going to add 1. That's totally valid too. So the completed the square version of y equals x squared plus 6x plus 10 is this. This is the completed the square version. We've completed the square on this question. Again, we can, if we want to, plug our numbers into the formula and we will get the same response. We'll get the same result rather. So this is our answer. Let's try another question out, guys. Let's try another one. Okay, guys, we've got another example here. We're taking a look at y equals x squared minus 16x minus 60, and we're going to be completing the square on it. Okay, so what's a? A is 1, isn't it? 1 lot of x squared, as we can clearly see there. What's b? Well, b is clearly 16, isn't it? Wrong, guys. You're silly. It's going to be minus 16. The minus in front matters, okay? So I'm making sure you're paying attention. B is minus 16. What's C? C is minus, again, 60, minus 60. Okay, let's do our normal technique. Open the bracket, chuck an X down. That's always what we do in every question, if A is 1. Okay, then we're going to add half of B. We're going to add, what's half of minus 16? Minus 8, right? So we're going to add minus 8. Okay, if we add minus 8, what that really says is just minus 8. Positive and a negative make a negative. And as always, we're going to square the whole thing. Beautiful. Okay, now, I'm going to tell you what this is. This right here, you can do it for yourself if you'd like to, is going to be x squared minus 16x plus 64, okay? You can do this if you want, but that's what that is if you expand that out using FOIL. Okay, so x squared, minus 16x, plus 64, minus 60. Okay, so we need to go from plus 64 to minus 60. We've got positive 64, we want minus 60. So what are we gonna take away or add maybe? We're going to, in this question, we're going to be taking away 124, it appears to be, right? Because 64 minus 124 is equal to minus 60. So we can rub this bit out. Complete the square version of this is gonna be this, okay? Brilliant. Good example. Let's try one more where a is actually not equal to 1, and let's see what happens. Okay then guys, we have got another question here. Y equals 4x squared plus 160x plus 400. Okay, positives, that's nice, but what's not nice is a 4 in front of our x squared. We don't normally want a 4 or any number that isn't 1 to be in front of our x squared. Okay, so if you get a question like this, you might be thinking, oh no, I don't know what to do. This is what you do. What you're gonna do is whatever is in front of the x squared, write that number, okay? Because we're gonna factor it out. So I'm gonna open up a bracket and I'm just going to write, everything in this bracket is gonna be 4 times smaller than what's up here. So x squared, 160x, that's gonna go to 40x. And 400 is gonna go to 100. Why? Well, 4 times x squared is 4x squared. 4 times 40x is 160x. 4 times 100 is 400. So this and this are equal. We've just factorized a 4 out. Why have we factorized a 4 out? Because now this thing here, this thing, we can complete the square on, and it's actually quite nice. So once again, I'm gonna rewrite. There's our 4. I'm gonna put 2 brackets down this time. I'm gonna tell you why in a second. Now we're gonna complete the square on this normal method. We're gonna do x, we're gonna add half of the b. B is 40 now. So we're gonna add 20. Close the bracket, square it. Okay, now we're gonna see what this thing is here. X plus 20 squared. Well, I'm gonna tell you, you can do this for yourself if you want. The answer to that is gonna be x squared plus 40x plus 400, because 20 squared is indeed 400. Okay, so this is actually very nice because it's kind of nice, it's kind of not nice. We have got 400. We don't want 400, we want 100. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna take away 300. Why? Because we're on 400, this gives us 400, and we want 100. Close bracket. So the reason why I wrote a double bracket here is because we've now got brackets inside more brackets. Everything is being times by 4. Okay. Hope we are still understanding. Now, we can expand this out, and we can say y is equal to 4 times x plus 20 squared, and then 4 times minus 300 is minus 1,200. And look at that, the square has been completed. Don't believe me, check it using the formula, and that is it. So the way that you complete the square, on functions of the form ax squared plus bx plus c, when a is not 1, is factor it out and then complete the square on what's left inside and then unfactor it, expand back out, and you will get that. I hope that made sense. I hope it was good stuff. If you enjoyed the video, please like, subscribe, share with your friends and math cohorts, and I will see you guys in the next video.